Okay, so this is the roof joist assignment for the garage. What we're going to start out by doing is we're going to start out by creating a 1 foot offset rectangle that's going to hang off the side of our current frame structure. If we go over to SketchUp, this is what you should have in terms of progress, albeit your concrete will have texture. Mine doesn't for the sake of demonstration. So we're going to get a top view. I find the easiest way to create that offset is we're just going to go here. We're going to do a 1 foot, 1 foot, right there. Now we've got our overhang. Now if you look at the window of the classroom, you see this most of the roofs on the school, on the outside especially, have an overhang. If you look at your house at home, there's an overhang. This exists so that when the rain or the snow slides off the roof, it'll fall on the ground and run away from the basic structure of the home, or in this case the garage, not settling into the foundation or the footing, disrupting the overall structure. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to erase this one line. So if we don't, it's going to kind of wreak havoc on some of our later operations. So if we go over to our instructions, it wants us to create a 5 foot line, which is going to be the peak of our house roof, or in this case, it's the garage roof. Okay, and that was our midpoint, so if you're not sure, double check, and it should be the same all the way around, and it is. Okay, we're going to join these two. We're going to need that line later. And it does fit in, which we're going to get rid of because we don't need that. Okay. Now the instructions, once that's done, ask us to create a secondary line, which is going to act as the bottom of our roof joist. It's going to look like this once it's done. And this board is going to be 1.5 inches thick, as are all the other structural boards that we're using for this assignment and most of our other assignments. So we're going to just use our tape measure. We're going to measure over 1.5 inches. Grab our rectangle, which is the suggested method to ensure a closed shape. And let's grab our pencil and let's begin our joist. So what we're going to do is we're going to go up here and touch this line. This is us telling Google SketchUp that I'm going to create a line and I want it to be parallel to this line. So we're going to go over and adjust our view. Okay, there we go. Click. Closed up, which is okay because that means that we have a closed object, which is what we want to have. Now, sometimes SketchUp will let you use the rectangle option. Other times it won't. And so what we're going to do is we're going to go from here, we're going to go 1.5 over, and we're going to draw a line. Click. Okay. Now SketchUp is going to ask you to draw a vertical line, 5 7/8 of an inch. So we're going to go over there and we're going to do that. Okay, now once that's done, we're going to grab our rectangle and get rid of our stuff. Now, you might think this is a bit of a pain, that this stuff keeps closing up, but it's kind of an insurance policy in a way. It's telling you that it is a closed object. So, okay, we're going to go up here, click. Everything's all closed up now. Perfect. That's exactly what we want. want. So what we're going to do now is we're going to, instead of drawing this over and over and over again, because at this point you're probably like, this is going to take a bit of work. We're going to turn this into a component. Yes. So let's turn it into a component. Click, right click component, make component. Okay. Now, let's pull this component out and see what we've got. So oftentimes when you make this into a component from that type of view, you're going to grab a whole bunch of extra stuff, sometimes more than others. So what we're going to do is we're going to edit our component so that we can get rid of the stuff that we did not want to grab. Okay, we got lucky this time. Sometimes you end up with the entire wall. Okay, got a little speck there, which is fine. Okay, perfect. Okay, so we've got our component, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over here, I'm going to draw a line, and I'm going to put this component right over there. Right there, okay. Now, you might be thinking we could just copy this over, which you can. Sometimes SketchUp is a little funny about allowing you to copy over the original component. So, nonetheless, it doesn't matter. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go click on that corner, and let's just overlay it over here. I'm going to go slash 18 enter, and we've got 18 copies. Okay, this is key. This joist sits on top of this vertical stud. The reason this is important is this is one of the major criteria in the marking scheme for this particular assignment. And what's important about this is that this transfers any weight that's on the roof down to the vertical stud, through that board, and into the foundation and the footing. And what load might that be? Well, that load might actually be snow, or if somebody's actually on the roof. So we're going to actually also have to copy this. Okay, we're going to put one up here, like so. Because you need a joist on each end. Okay. Now I'll get you started on the other side. All you have to do is go down to our lumber pile. Okay, click. Bring it over. You should be able to manually go 180. If not, you can key it in. Now, if everything's correct, you should just be able to go right up to here and join that to your joist, and it should sit directly on top of that vertical joist, or the vertical stud, which it is. Perfect. That's it for the joist assignment. You're obviously going to have to complete the remainder of the roof.